So jumping over to my cast lever component, as I mentioned, I've already done the design process, and we can see down here across the bottom of the file that it is, you know, just kind of traditional parametric modeling tools, pick and place features, some sketches with dimensions in them and so on. And very quickly, I can take this file and jump from where it is to the simulation space. And within the simulation, I can specify what type of simulation I'm trying to run. So in this case, I'm just going to do a static stress analysis, create that study. There are some inputs that it's going to give me automatically. So you'll see here, it's got this quick setup here. I don't need this. I know how to run it. So I'm going to close that. And then, you know, the UI in this has automatically updated to give me the information that I'm after. So within this model, we can see that it's made out of aluminum. If I did want to change the material, I can adjust this. And so we have in here access to a plethora of various materials that would work. Some of them do not, right? Carpet doesn't work because it doesn't have mechanical properties embedded in it. But we can also build our own material libraries to find all of our mechanical and stress and thermal properties on that material and have access to them as well. For the sake of the exercise, I'm going to use just standard aluminum. Now that I have that finished, I could go through the process of simplifying the design. And within the simplify design tool, it allows me to do things like remove specific features. So for the sake of simplicity for a simulation, I probably don't need the fillets. Right? So I can come in and say, let's go ahead and remove those specific fillets on the part in order to try to clean up the overall shape of this. Now, in my case, I'm not going to accept this because this part's not that complicated. But if I were working on a very complex, say, plastic part or, you know, a very complex, maybe five-axis machined component where it's got a lot of blends, a lot of features in it, the simulation side doesn't really necessarily need them. And so I can simplify it during this process and just simplify it during that environment. That's a big deal, right? When thinking about working within like Inventor, for example, if I want to make a simplified version of the component, I may have to even go as far as saving a copy of it off, you know, because I may have to go in and like delete or suppress a whole slew of features in here. This environment has its own simplification and it's stored only in this environment, which gives me a lot of flexibility when working with these parts. As far as creating constraints, pretty straightforward, right? I know I'm going to pin a couple of these locations, so we're just going to pin those in place. I'm then going to apply a load to this component. And in this case, I just want to define this based on the vector itself. So in this case, instead of extruding it or doing the direction downward, I'm just going to choose a new edge. And then from here, I can just specify the force on that component. In this case, we're just going to say that it's 250 pounds force on that component. Change the unit, pound force. There we go. Okay. So in this case, I've specified the force that I want to apply in that location. Kind of working my way down the line. I don't have any contacts. I'm working in the assembly environment. Fusion does not care, right? If you want to run simulations on an assembly, you can define the contacts amongst those components within the space. And you can, there's a contact manager that gives you all of the various contacts that are between those components. What I really like about this is that I can very quickly jump back and forth between the various ways to view this data. Within a lot of the other simulation tools, this dialogue doesn't exist. And so you're stuck with just looking at the contact sets where you see like this list of, you know, 50 contacts for 6 or 8 components. And you have to suss out, okay, are all of my contacts in existence? Whereas in here, I can see, okay, this component is touching these objects. This component is touching these objects. And it makes a lot more logical sense of what you're dealing with. In this case, I don't have the mesh generated yet. So let's go ahead and get into the mesh settings. I am going to shrink this down a little bit. And I could come in and specify absolute sizes of the mesh elements. If you're not familiar with the FEA process, generally you define all of your conditions of the model, and then we break it down into a mesh object, which is just a bunch of small triangular pyramids. We then use those for the calculations. The mesh refinement controls really just how clean or how accurate the data is to a point. We don't want to go too fine because it'll take a long time to solve, but we also don't want it too coarse because then you're losing precision. So you have to kind of find that happy medium. There is a whole lot of options in here, and this is where the quote unquote art of the mesh comes in, which is way outside of the scope of this conversation. In my case, not getting into the advanced settings, I'm just going to dial this down a little bit. Tell it to generate the mesh. Let this process for a moment. Generate a mesh. Typically, at this point, I would then kind of take a peek at it to see, okay, is there anywhere in here that it looks really weird? There's a couple spots where I'm getting like cords that are missing, but for the sake of this, I'm not super concerned. The part itself is not that complicated, so it should be just fine with what I'm working with. So from here, I've got the loads, the material, the contact or the constraints, no contacts needed, and the parts meshed. So from here, I'm going to run the pre-check. It says, hey, this has everything I need. So for those who are not used to running this process or not used to running the CAE workflow, there's a nice built-in tool to just make sure, hey, you've got stuff defined in a way that makes sense. Hey, here's some things that will run but not run well. And then from here, I can then solve it. This does not cost any cloud credits because this is just a single static stress. However, if I did want to run a more complicated simulation, there are some costs potentially associated to it, especially for like the dynamics studies where collision impacts and things like that, the solves are fairly involved. So, but from here, we're just going to solve this. It's going to take a moment. On the left-hand side at the bottom of the data field, we can see the simulation progress. And within that window, it's going to kind of give us some input. Additionally, up here, we'll see our status field.